Hello everyone, in this video I am going to demonstrate to you fourth ventricle. As we know, fourth ventricle is the cavity of hindbrain. It is situated between pons and upper part of medulla oblongata anteriorly and cerebellum posteriorly. Here we can see this cavity over here. This is the cavity of fourth ventricle. Communication. See, in this specimen we can see its communication above. This fourth ventricle is having communication with the cavity of midbrain. Here we can see this is the aqueduct of sylvius or cerebral aqueduct of midbrain. So above it is having communication with the cerebral aqueduct of midbrain, below it is having communication with the central canal of medulla oblongata, and through the roof it is having communication with the subarachnoid space of cisterna magna through three foramen. They are foramen of Magendie and a pair of foramen of Lusca. Boundaries of fourth ventricle. Lateral boundaries are formed by supralaterally by the superior cerebellar peduncles, inferolaterally by inferior cerebellar peduncles. They are forming lateral boundaries into roof. Here we can see roof is formed by cerebellum, anterior aspect of cerebellum, that is forming the roof of the fourth ventricle. If we cut it, it looks like this. See, we can say it is in the sagittal section. It is tent shaped or triangular in shape. Its roof is formed by superior medullary vellum and inferior medullary vellum, which is not present. This superior medullary vellum is basically a thin sheet of white matter which bridges the gap between two superior cerebellar peduncles. Here this is the superior medullary vellum, and that inferior medullary vellum, which is supposed to be over here, it is mainly made up of tela choroidea, that is the pia mater, and ependyma of fourth ventricle. So this is about the roof. Now coming to the floor. Here in this view we can see the floor of fourth ventricle, which is formed by pons and upper part of medulla oblongata. We can see it is diamond shaped or rhomboid shaped, so it is also called rhomboid fossa. Now what are the features of floor of fourth ventricle? Here we can see in the central portion there is a sulcus which is called median sulcus. This is median sulcus. On both the sides of median sulcus there are aminence. They are called median aminence. Median aminence. From the median sulcus we can see this white stria going laterally. They are called stria medullaris. So this is median sulcus, median aminence. Lateral to the median aminence again there is a sulcus that is called sulcus limitans. The area lateral to the sulcus limitans, this area which is lateral to the sulcus limitans, is called vestibular area because vestibular nuclei are present beneath this. This is the site or of junction of pons and medulla oblongata. So this is the vestibular area, and medial aspect of the sulcus limitans we can see a colliculus, a pair of colliculi. They are called facial colliculi. Beneath this motor nucleus of abducens nerve is present, which is hooked around by motor fibers of facial nerve. So it is called facial colliculus. Can you see this facial colliculus? Okay, now if we trace this sulcus limitans above and below, Okay, first above, if we trace it, there is a depression that is called superior fovea, and above the superior fovea, this bluish discolored area is present. Can you see this area? This bluish discolored area is called locus ceruleus, which contain nerve cells having melanin pigment, and they produce substantia ferruginea. So this is locus ceruleus. Now if we trace this sulcus limitans below, again there is a depression, this depression is called inferior fovea. Below the inferior fovea, the sulcus limitans, it converges towards the median eminence and divides this area into two triangles, triangle above and medially. This is called hypoglossal triangle, which contain hypoglossal nuclei, and the area below and laterally is called vagal triangle, which contains motor nuclei of vagus nerve. And again there is a faint ridge, which divides this vagal triangle or separates this vagal triangle from another area here, that is called area postrema, that is chemoreceptor trigger zone. This is the higher center for vomiting. Clear? This lowermost pointed part of the floor is called calamus cryptorius. On both the sides of this lateral boundaries, infralateral boundaries, which is not present over here, but white fibers are running over here. They are called tenia, and this tenia, they merge over here, and this point is called obex. This is all about floor of the fourth ventricle.